Well, that's where we're looking at now, the clash, the continued clash, it would seem, between farmers and herdsmen. And joining us to discuss that is Major General Garba Wahab, who's retired, a former director of operations in the Army headquarters and GOC 1 Division and Chief of Army Admin. Well, all of that was when you were in service. You're welcome to Sunrise Daily.
Thank you very much.
You've seen this recurring decimal, it would seem, farmers and herdsmen clashes. From your perspective, what do you think the problem is, and how do you think we can get a solution?
Thank you very much. This is not the first time we're mentioning this issue here. Mm-hmm. And I remember the last time I came here, I mentioned the fact that most of the cattle routes had virtually been developed. I give an example of the Kaduna Abuja Expressway. It cuts through a lot of cattle routes. These guys are coming from so many places. DRC, the Republic of Congo, from Niger, from Chad, from Mali, from everywhere. And there is a route which they used to take. And these have virtually been developed. So there is no way they will not move into farmlands. It's an occupational clash. Farmers and herdsmen, the two cannot meet.
But the casualties we're recording, yeah. Isn't it alarming?
It is. It is. But a simple solution. Somewhere along the line, the U.S. ambassador to Nigeria, I think some few days ago, mentioned the need for us to establish ranches. And a lot of people, including myself, have said, look, we need to go back to grazing reserves. People are afraid. We are natives. We want to hold on to our lands. And yet, we don't want clashes. We have to reduce the fault lines, create grazing reserves, create grazing areas, whether you call it ranches or whatever. Let people move to those areas when they are coming in.
For a lot of people, they are fundamental. There's a fundamental difference between ranches and grazing mm-hmm. reserves.
Yes.
Grazing reserves is just land earmarked by government.
Yes.
Ranches are personal
property
owned by
yes.
people, and
yes.
they believe that that's the way to go.
The Americans started, don't forget they have the same movement of cattle with somebody on horses and people on horses driving their cattle because of weather.
The cowboys.
The cowboys. But over time, laws were made and laws were obeyed. In Nigeria, we have rules, we have regulations. People hardly obey instructions. They hardly obey rules. And so, whatever you call it, those who have the money to establish ranches could do so. But the government need to look at the poor ones who just go about, the nomadic Fulani guys who go about taking their cattle from one point to the other. Those are the ones that actually need grazing reserves. But the rich farmers or the rich cattle owners, yes, this is the normal problem in Nigeria. Somebody buy a trailer and you want the government to provide you with where to park your trailers. It's not known anywhere in the world. It's only in Nigeria. You go and buy so many trailers, you have about 1,500 trailers, and you expect the government to provide where you park those trailers. And if the government does not provide, you park them in the middle of the road and you start having problems. So a lot of things are wrong, and we have to start looking at solutions to them. And one of the ways out is to create grazing reserves for those who don't have the money or who are not rich cattle owners. And then for those who have the resources, they need to be forced to be enforced to establish ranches.
Well, General, we have to take a moment now. When we return, we'll continue our conversation in just a moment. Don't go away. Welcome back. Major General Garba Wahab, retired, is still with us in the studio. Just going to ask you quickly. Mm. You have said that, you know, we have the people who can afford it should ranch their cows. And
yes.
for those who are poor, who cannot afford it, the government should provide grazing reserves.
Yeah.
Now, we have heard that a lot of people who commit these atrocities are not from Nigeria. Do you agree with that perspective?
Yeah, it's possible because you have Fulani tribal something runs from Senegal up there down to the Democratic Republic of Congo. And it's a free movement issue. And people can come from DRC down to Nigeria. And those guys are battle tested. They have weapons. They carry their weapons all over the place. The same thing goes from Mali because of the issue of Hakim. And if you add this to the fact that you have over 74 million AK-47 rifles in circulation all over the world, this crisis needs to be tackled immediately.
So if they're coming into Nigeria to graze their cattle and we cannot stop them, are we going to be providing grazing reserves for them as well?
Well, you see, that's where a lot of issues are to come in. You have to have a sort of ministerial committee. ECOWAS free movement issue is there. You can't run away from that. And so that involves Minister of Foreign Affairs, Minister of Agri. A lot of things have to come in. People have to really sit down and look at what do we do. We don't. The same problem we have in the Northeast. The average Canary man can go across to Chad and come to Nigeria and create problem, create havoc. The same thing in the western part of Nigeria. The Ajashers are there. They move from Benin Republic to places like Shangwat and whatever in Nigeria. So these are issues that we need to really look at seriously. And until we sit down and look at, do we actually work on the national identity or have a way of identifying these are Nigerians? And you solve the problems for Nigerians. And then those who are foreigners, you treat them as intruders. Then we continue to have this issue.
Can we ever get to that point? Because people say
we have
that
to.
Our borders are porous.
Yeah, the borders
are
porous.
People already have roots.
The borders are porous.
Are we going to ever be able to stop them?
There is nothing is impossible. There is nothing you cannot do once you have the will to do it. The Americans have the same problem. All of a sudden, people are shouting, why is President Trump thinking of building the Mexico wall? Because he believed he had to safeguard his citizens. We have to do something about that too in Nigeria. It is possible.
It is possible.
It is possible.
Well, that's where we'll have to leave it. Retired Major General Garba Wahab, who is former Director of Operations at Army Headquarters and also Commander of GOC 1 Division. Well, thank you for coming on Sunrise Daily.
Thank you very much, Mona.
Well, that will be it from us here in Abuja. We've had a very fruitful discussion, I want to believe. And that's where we'll wrap it up. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Maokwe Ogun. I hand you over now to Chimberlain and Gimba.
Well, yes, indeed. Let's quickly take a comment. Dende writing in from Lagos about the screening. He sends in his email this morning, and he's talking about the fact that, I thought we're going to see that, guys. Okay, well.
Here it is.
Yes, then he says, permit me to chip in his view on this matter. He says, for him, the presidency should put his house in order. The DSS shouldn't be portrayed as countering the president. The presidency bungled the whole process. In going forward, there are a million other eminently qualified Nigerians who can do the EFCC job. That's Dende writing it from Lagos. Well, we'll see several other comments. We'll appreciate them, but we'll hopefully take them all tomorrow. Thank you for watching. I'm Chamberlain Usa.
Many thanks for watching. I am Gimba Omar.